We're right in the middle of jackfruit season, and Berica sent me this beautiful kattal, or raw jackfruit, as well as the ripe one. So I decided, why not make a combined dish with it? And since the monsoons are around the corner, how about a kattal pakoda sandwich with a ripe jackfruit chutney? Yum. Okay, let's get started. For ingredients, you'll need besan, you'll need green chilies, ginger, onion, cilantro, hing, turmeric powder, garam masala powder, shai jeera, red chili powder, chaat masala, rice flour, and of course raw jackfruit. To start with, you're going to clean the jackfruit. Make sure you put enough oil on the knife and your hands so you don't get sticky, and slowly cut away the skin, keeping the kattal vertical. Make sure you wipe out all that excess sap that comes out of it, and then break it up. Make sure you cut off the center core that's not really edible, and then cut it into manageable size pieces. Keep them soaked in water so they don't discolor, and you can put away the rest of the kattal by just wrapping it in a newspaper and keeping it in the refrigerator. Now on to the rest of the prep. We need to cut up the aromatics. Let's start with the onions. You need to slice them thinly. So we first take off the core like I just did, and then slice them lengthwise. I've sped up the video so it looks like I'm cutting really fast, but I haven't. Okay, on to the green chilies. Take off the ends, make a slit, and then chop them up finely. Do the same for the dhania or the cilantro as well. Chop it up pretty finely. Don't worry about the stems. And ginger, you want to cut the ginger into a fine chop. So slice them and then cut them into julienne, long slices like that, and then go through them again and cut them really fine. Alright, first things first, we need to cook the kattal in a pressure cooker preferably, so it save a lot of time. Heat up with enough water to cover. And add turmeric powder, a generous amount of hing, gives a nice sourness to it. Lots and lots of salt, and then just cover it and cook on high pressure. So typically this is going to take about 5 to 7 minutes after the first whistle is when you can turn it off, and I like to release the pressure from the pressure cooker so that I save time. Easy hack. Just be careful though, make sure it's completely cooled down before you open it. And there you go, this cooked kattal. And at this stage you can drain it out and use it for any of your kattal preparations. In this case, we're going to make the pakoda mix, starting with gently crushed shai jeera seeds, which are going into the drained kattal. And to that, we're going to add the sliced onions, chopped green chilies, the chopped ginger, and the chopped cilantro. We're gonna add a garam masala powder. I'm using Chef Floyd Cardo's garam masala on burlap and barrel. Generous amount of Kashmiri red chili powder, the non-spicy variety. And it's going to need some more salt because we added like a whole bunch of other stuff in there. And then mix all of this together until you get a semi-homogeneous mix. Yeah, get your hands in there, get them dirty. And at this stage, I'm going to add the flours. This is besan. It's about, let's say about 1/2 to 3/4 of a cup. In this particular recipe, I'm not really adding any water. I'm using the whatever moisture is there in the ingredients, and that's about a little bit of rice flour, maybe 1/4 cup of rice flour. And the rice flour is what gives it that crispiness. Looks like it needs a little more besan, so I'm going to add some more besan in there. And your pakoda mixture is ready to fry. It stores in the refrigerator and use it later as well. Now get a pot of oil hot. The ideal temperature is going to be around 170 to 180 degrees Celsius, But you can dip in maybe a slice of onion to make sure it's hot enough. And yeah, just add kind of little morsels or dumplings of the pakora. It doesn't have to be a certain shape. In fact, the irregularity of the shape is what's fun about this pakora. Make sure you don't overcrowd the pot too much, but you can add enough for one layer of pakoras. Oh my god, that looks so good already. Turn them over so they fry evenly, and when they are like a nice dark deep golden brown, you can pull them out. Actually, I don't know why people say golden brown. This is not really golden brown, this is brown brown. Alright, pull them out, and as soon as they're out, I like to dust them generously with some chaat masala. In this case, a chunky variety. And this is what gives it that nice chatpata flavor to it. And your pakora is ready. Alright, moving on to the chutney. We have groundnut oil, curry leaves, ginger, chopped garlic, star anise, dry red chili, cumin seeds, hing, mustard seeds, Kashmiri red chili powder, turmeric powder, some tamarind, onion, and of course the ripe jackfruit. Okay, we're gonna start with soaking the tamarind in some hot water so you can make a tamarind pulp puree. So just soak it in there for about 15-20 minutes in piping hot water, and then we'll move on to getting our onions ready. I'm gonna chop them up finely so they kind of dissolve into the chutney later once we cook them. There's a basic technique for chopping onions that I follow, which is really easy. It's also on one of my reels. And then we move on to chopping the jackfruit up. You want to take off the seeds, and the seeds, there's an inner lining that coats the seeds, and you want to remove that as well. And once you remove these from all of the pieces of jackfruit, you cut them lengthwise into thin strips like so, and then chop them up horizontally so that you get nice tiny pieces of delicious ripe jackfruit. Jackfruit actually reminds me a lot of my grandmom. She used to have it for us very often during my childhood, make this kind of halwa with it, which is really yummy. It's a fruit I really, really love. Okay, time to start cooking now, now that we have all our prep ready. Heat a pot on low flame. Add your groundnut oil or any neutral vegetable oil. And then start adding the whole spices, starting with mustard seeds and fenugreek seeds. Allow these two to splutter very briefly for a few seconds, and then add dry red chili and the star anise. Star anise is going to give a nice lovely flavor to the final chutney. Again, cook for a few seconds, add hing, and soon after you add the hing, you want to add the aromatics, because the hing burns very quickly. So add the chopped onions, stir nicely to combine so that none of the spices are burning. This is also when I'm going to season and add a generous amount of salt. And once the onions are kind of translucent and cooked half the way through, that's when you add the remaining aromatics, the chopped ginger, the curry leaves, and the chopped garlic. Again, cook until a lot of that raw flavor, raw aroma kind of dissipates. And slightly starts to brown. You don't want to brown all the way through. At this stage, I'm going to add the spice powders. So, turmeric powder and Kashmiri red chili powder.
poke this out for a few seconds. And then we add our star ingredient, the finely chopped ripe jackfruit. It's very rare that you see ripe jackfruit in a savory kind of preparation, and this is a great example of it. It's a lovely chutney. It gets better as it ages, so let it sit in your fridge for a few days before you actually eat it. In this case, it's going to go with our lovely kattal pakoda. Okay, I'm going to add some water. And then you need to be a little patient. This needs to cook for about 20 to 30 minutes on a slow flame so it doesn't burn. And all that sugar is going to kind of come out of the jackfruit, thicken up the chutney. The jackfruit is going to soften nicely. And if you want to add more water at any stage, feel free to do that. But you'll start to see the color change as well, and that's the sugar caramelizing slowly. All those spices and aromatics and flavors melding together beautifully. Okay, I'm going to add a little bit of water and continue to cook this for another 7 to 10 minutes. And of course, you can add your tamarind at this stage as well. And the tamarind is added to taste, so you want it to be the sourness to balance out the sweetness of the jackfruit. And remember that it's going to thicken up once it cools down. So at about this consistency is when you can turn it off. And your chutney is pretty much ready. And now here you have it. The kattal pakoda pav sandwich with a ripe jackfruit chutney. Enjoy.